Hi everybody. Today is Friday, May 8th, and I wanted to share some information with you so that when you hear all of the headlines about the unemployment and the economy going down or the real estate market going down, I just wanted to show you some real information, share with you what's happening on the market, and let you make your own conclusions based on facts and numbers, both nationally and really locally. So let's start with national statistics just to show you what we are seeing, and you can make your own decisions. So we get prognosis, I guess. We get estimations from big companies, and you see here that the four big companies, Goldman Sachs, JP Morgan, Morgan Stanley, Wells Fargo, are predicting that by quarter four, we actually will see some growth. Yes, we will see the falling down, but it's not going to last too long. And of course, if you need to see where this information is coming from, let me know. I will get you the sources. We do have a showing time company that is the vendor that helps us agents to organize viewings for our clients. And according to that company's statistics and actual data, nationwide, the number of showings, be it in person or virtual, actually is going up starting beginning of April, and it's going up quite sharply. That tells us that people are still out there. It's a pent-up demand. Buyers are still looking to buy. They kind of dropped off a little bit, but then decided to go ahead and start looking again. And I'm seeing it with people who are calling me as well, saying, "Hey, you know, we just kind of delayed our purchase, but we still want to purchase. So why don't we just go ahead and start again looking?" So you will see that that's the true picture in the whole country and specifically in our area as well. You will also see that nationwide, the home ownership percentage actually is growing, but this is just year of over year, and we are seeing a growth in that. So that's a very encouraging sign. And the reason for that is because the rent is going up. Asking rent is going up steadily and actually quite strong. And me being a landlord, I actually see that the market shows me that I can actually ask higher rent, and I see people applying for our properties like crazy. So we do see a huge demand from people who need to rent, but prices are not going down and they're not going to go down anytime soon. So a lot of people are deciding to buy instead. The reason that we are not thinking that this is a return of 2008 in terms of the housing market crash is because this is the new statistics. This is updated information. Before I shared a slide with you where it says 37% of nationwide homeowners actually have 100% equity, meaning no mortgage. Well, it actually went up. It's 42.1% now. But if you look at this chart, you will see that actually 16.6% of people have equity over 60%. Another 12.5% have equity over 40%, 41%. So that's people are not going to walk away from that equity. People are not going to go into foreclosure. And that is very encouraging for us when we are talking about real estate market crash. So this is very important slide for you to see that nationwide, over 58% of population who owns home, who own homes, right, have at least 60% equity. So people are not going to walk away from that. So don't expect another wave of foreclosures or short sales anytime soon. You hear the headlines about unemployment, and they are really bad, yes. But let's look at actually what type of jobs are being lost. And the trend of the unemployment itself. So if you see this graph, it's kind of losing steam, I guess. But most importantly, I want you to take a look at this one. Statistically, from the Bureau of Labor as of May 8th, you will see that the types of jobs that are lost are quite industry specific. The brunt of it all is servers and bartenders. The next one are going to be retail and temporary services. Most majority of jobs are not suffering as much as those are. So I'll give you a second to take a look at this graph, and if you want to pause this video and actually really look at the numbers and the industries, I would also like you to pay attention to this one. You will see that actually 90% of job losses are temporary, meaning people are applying, people kind of want to be fired because they can then apply for unemployment benefits. For example, me as a real estate agent, actually, I am self-employed, so I cannot apply for unemployment benefits. Not that I need to, because we still have business going, but a lot of the Redfin agents were furloughed or let go. And the conversation among other agents was like, well, at least they can now apply for unemployment. So that will tell you that people want to be furloughed or let go of to apply for unemployment benefits, but the job losses are mostly temporary. And you will see that, yes, it's 14.7% unemployment rate, but 85%, over 85% are still employed. Take a look at this breakdown. 13% of adult men are unemployed, 15.5% adult women, but almost 32% are teenagers. Interesting. Now, we are continuously looking at projections from big companies, economists, and experts, and we keep coming back to this graph where you will see that the Great Recession lasted 9 years, Great Depression lasted 12 years, meaning it took 9 or 12 years, respectively, to get to the same level of economy before the crisis took place. Well, for today's economy crisis, the projections are that it's not going to take more than 2 years. So we're not going to keep sitting in this bottom for a long time. We're going to hit it, but we're going to go back to normal and then exceed that normal in about 2 years. And that's, at least it's going to be painful, but at least it's not going to be too long of a pain. When you look at the headlines and they say, oh my God, the housing is going down because unemployment rates are so high, nobody's going to buy houses. Please remember that before we went into this crisis, we had extreme deficit of inventory. We had extremely strong sellers market. We had a lot of buyers. We didn't have enough homes to sell them, and we are still experiencing it. And so we're still, look at this one. This is interesting. This is nationwide. And as of February 20th, the latest we could get the statistics for is March. So right now you will see that in February, look at how many sellers are not on the market really. The seller traffic is kind of there, but it's not as robust. And look at March, how badly it went down, as opposed to buyer's traffic. In February 2020, all states had deficit of homes, and we had very strong buyer's market. In March, we still have more than half of the country buyer's market. Buyer's traffic is quite strong, and we will see this actually improving in April, May, based on what I'm seeing. And this is where we're going back to our localities. I just want to share with you some of our counties here in Northern Virginia. I will post a link where you can check your own county or subdivision or neighborhood. Please bear in mind, because I don't work in Maryland, I only can share this information with you for Virginia. But if you take a look at Arlington, as of May 7th, we see that the days on the market went up, and but the price, basically, you can call it a stable, but that's the only county where the price is actually in red. Look at Fairfax County. In the last 30 days, yes, days on the market slightly higher, but the price went up. And I'm seeing this, you know where I'm seeing this? I'm seeing this in when I show houses and my clients want to put an offer, and it turns out we are competing again and again and again. We have one, two, three, four, five offers coming in the first 24 to 48 hours. It's insane. Of course, price will go up. Loudoun County, same thing. Days are slightly more on the market, but we're seeing the same thing. I experienced this in late last week when my clients decided not to compete because it was way too much. But the listing agent told me that she had three offers in the first 24 hours of house being on the market. Again, insane. Look at Prince William County. In the last 30 days, slightly higher numbers of days on the market. The price is stable, but it's still in green. This is the information that will tell you that even if you want to look at nation statistics, we're still in good shape. But locally in Northern Virginia, in DC suburbs, we are in still a very strong housing market. We're still experiencing deficit of homes for sale. So if you are thinking about selling your home, please, please, please do it. We don't have enough homes for sale right now on the market. We have many buyers. You will have absolutely no problem selling your home. Reach out to me. I'll tell you what you can do to sell it even faster and for more money. For like really not much of an investment into your home, you can make it really shine and you can have buyers fight over it. So definitely a good time to go ahead and list your home. And don't you worry about being exposed to virus. We have things we are doing now to protect our clients, both sellers and buyers. So we have things that will protect you. So don't think that because of this virus you have to sit on the house and you don't want, you cannot sell it. You absolutely can, and this is probably a good time to do it. Not probably, for sure, a good time to do it. You saw how strong of a deficit we are experiencing right now, and any agent you talk to will tell you the same thing if they are worth the, if they're good agents. But anyway, so I just wanted to share this with you, and hope this information is helpful. Happy Mother's Day, and I will hopefully talk to you soon. Bye.